Stand still.
Move across.
Stand still.
Sit.
When your back's against the wall, we have to see who is willing to go to the edge. Do you have what it takes to be one of us?
Tighten up! Suffer in silence!
In this series, an elite team of ex-Special Forces soldiers.
Keep pushing! Let's go!
From the UK and USA. Have combined their skills to create the toughest course yet.
What's the way? The carrier's getting there now! Let's go!
Bringing together the most grueling elements of Special Forces selection.
Come on!
From both sides of the Atlantic.
America's bringing something to the table!
This is a combination of the best fighting forces in the world.
Yes! I'm going to Vegas, baby!
Collaboration with our brothers in arms has gone on for years. The American process is based on ours, but it's even more brutal.
I want the recruits to learn through pain.
This is a warm-up. Now we're gonna get to the real game. Let's go, Mountain Goats!
Each recruit must go beyond the physical.
Get the tire!
To come face to face with their true character.
You better not stop again or I'm dropping your ass.
No other test asks as much.
Keep working. Do not give up.
Or means as much.
Be proud of yourself. It all net. Good man.
Patty, give me something. Yeah.
To the few who make it through.
Good job, both of you. Thanks so much.
Welcome to the slaughterhouse, little lambs.
It's just like stuck to my scalp. I don't know where it is. I didn't see one.
I think I've got like 4 hours sleep.
Oof. That was a hell of a fart. Just checking.
Recruits! Out on the parade square!
Okay.
It's the third phase of the course, and of the 20 recruits who began, 18 remain.
The most powerful individual asset an SF soldier possesses is his mind. The mind is what frames the individual warrior's complete reality. We're stepping into a new phase, and we're gonna have some very serious exposés of character and mindset. All right, get your Bergens, head on out to the vehicles.
For the Special Forces community, mindset is everything.
I think today's going to be designed to take out a lot of people.
And it ain't going to be anyone in this car, is it?
No.
When you are in an enemy land...
Keep it going. Let's go. All the way up.
You must compartmentalize your pain and fear to accomplish the mission.
Yes, God!
If you do not have that ability, you will not survive.
Right, ditch your Bergens here.
The recruits are at the Red Sea port of Aqaba, where they will face a fear test designed by Special Forces training to instill trust and courage.
Hey, listen up, pay attention. The backwards dive is a test of mindset in the face of fear and the unknown. You will not hesitate, and don't fuck this up.
Watch and get it right.
Thank you.
The perfect demonstration.
The recruits must cross their arms and drop 7 meters head first into the dock below.
Number eight.
Right. When you get up there, get your heels over the edge of the platform so they're free.
Yes.
At 26 years old, number eight Paige is the youngest female on the course.
Don't look down and don't push your arse out.
I do think people underestimate us. See, I was always known as ditzy, and I used to always get told I was living in fluffy bunny land.
Inhale.
So I kind of do everything in my will to prove otherwise, I suppose.
Go!
Oof. That's what you do not want to do.
Number eight, shite. Diabolical. Fail. Next recruit!
How's it going, number 17?
Good.
Recruit number 17, Parnia, is next up.
You wouldn't clock it straight away, but I sometimes get imposter syndrome.
All right, 17.
Yes, sir.
You've received your instructions?
Honestly, I will try my hardest to keep face and look confident. You'll fake it till you make it. I've lived by this.
Deep inhale.
Turn up as you hope to be and just hide the fear.
Go! What the fuck was that? Face plant, number 17. Fail. Hold and fall. Simple. You're not splitting the atom, you're just falling off a platform. Can't get that right. The size of some of your fucking heads. Go! Cross your arms. Focus, focus. Deep breath. Hold your breath. Go!
This backwards dive is about pushing the recruits.
Go!
To control their fear.
Stand by. Hold.
I remember when I first jumped out of a plane from a very high altitude.
Go!
I was scared to death. But I didn't think about it. I just jumped. And that moment I jumped, I defeated fear.
Perfect!
I beat it. And that's what we want our recruits to do.
Bunch of amateurs! Next recruit!
Arms across your chest, body rigid. Do not forget that.
Next up to the platform is number 12, James.
Hold your nerve. That's all you have to do.
Stuff.
Crack on.
Number 12, on me. Calm down. You've received your instructions?
Yes, stuff.
Big inhale, cross the arms. Go!
Holy shit.
What?
How was that?
You fucking bellend! Oi! You think you're in a fucking circus? Showboating. Muppet. Thing was, it was just either not listening, hesitant, or...
Circus
clown. In the fucking, which really pissed me off.
Yeah.
Showboat, and that was number 12. Playing the game, wants to be different, so we'll make him fucking different.
Oh, 100%.
On the basis of that, well, I was disappointed. If anybody's here for pure self-gain, and it's all about me, give me your armband now. You know exactly what I'm talking about, don't you?
Stuff.
Don't you?
Stuff.
Well, you know what? Because of you, I guess what's going to happen? They're going to pay for this.
Stuff.
You're not. You can come and sit with me and chill the fuck out. Turn to your right. Put that down. Number 12, out you come. Chill out. Sit down. Chill. Think about your actions.
Fucks.
When I say go, you two will race. Stand by. Go! Go! Down and waddle. Fucking hurry up. Get your ass down. Get your ass below your knees. You can say thank you to number 12. For fucking around and trying to show off.
Everything we do on selection is a test. It's a test of your mind, a test of your character.
Pick your Bergens up on the way back to Billy.
Joe, get your Bergens and fucking hurry up. Tell them.
Get your Bergens and hurry up.
Some people can take the punishment on for themselves, but when you see somebody else suffering, a lot of people can't cope with that.
On your feet, back to Billy.
You have to control your mind, otherwise it will eat you up.
If you don't start shouting at them, I'm going to keep them going for another 5 minutes. You're only the fuck up, you lazy fuckers.
Hurry.
I want to hear you.
Hurry up, lazy fuckers.
Keep pushing. Keep pushing. Keep pushing. Let's go, eight, right here. Get lower, number 20.
Okay.
Either get low or take off your van. It's one or the other.
Yeah. I can't fucking do it, Steph. Thanks for everything, Steph.
You can hold your head high, you understand that?
Yes, Steph.
Hold your head high.
Leo is the third recruit to withdraw from the course. 17 remain.
You're my fucking dog. Start barking now.
Keep moving! Move!
Number two!
Get
down, number two!
Get moving!
The recruits are being beasted as punishment for number 12 James's poor performance on the backwards dive.
Arse is down!
I am reasonably mentally strong, but there's definitely a breaking point with me.
Get moving!
If I feel like I'm struggling,
keep moving!
I do have a tendency to kind of quit on myself. I can't believe I'm saying that, but it's the truth.
I know it hurts! It's supposed to hurt.
Sprint, number three!
Can't hear you. If I have one more silence, I am going to add another 10 minutes.
Stuff. I can't.
Want a VW?
Yes, I can't.
OK. Get your kit, grab your Bergen. Come wait over there.
Number 12, James, hands in his armband. And the DS called time on the bee sting.
Follow me.
Now, 16 recruits remain.
Run my ass, my fucking cute little butt. Get behind it.
Oh, fucking gutted me all gone. Gutted.
I know, I was just getting to know him, like.
I can only imagine how James be feeling.
In general, everyone, I believe, is regressing a little bit. What do you think, guys?
I think there's a few borderline waiting to pull the plug, waiting to go. That you can just read in the face.
And you know, and I agree with you, it's hard to ignore.
I think there is still shit that needs separating.
To shake out the deadwood now.
Let's do it.
Recruits, cover down in your vehicles and load up.
On selection, there comes a time when certain people just aren't doing enough to justify their position on the course. We have to put them through the mixer to see if they've got the grit and determination to get to the end.
Guys, we are in a valley of sand dunes.
Anxiety is kicking in now. I'm like, what?
The DS have designed a task to whittle out the weak on the 400-metre high Manishir sand dune.
Welcome to the slaughterhouse, little lambs.
This is what we call a route march. It requires mindset, grit and determination. It is going to be fucking hard. I want to see some desire to want a beer at the end of the course.
Yes, sir.
Let's go!
In a task of endurance and searing temperatures, the recruits must race up the sand to an RV point at the top of the dune. Carrying over 15 kilos in their Bergens.
Get on the rock and move your fucking ass.
I've been in situations in southern Afghanistan where it was blisteringly hot.
Get up with the DS now! Come on!
We needed to move at speed up a mountain. I was carrying a SATCOM radio, I was carrying two mortar bombs, I was carrying my own weapon systems and ammunition. Yeah, it's a fucking nightmare.
Hey!
17, let's go!
Taking an early lead is recruit number 17, Pania.
I consider myself a leader. I hate faffing around. I like to get from A to B as efficiently, as quickly as possible. So if I'm the one to help lead people to do that, I will happily step up.
One, I want to see more effort.
As the temperature on the sand dune approaches 35 degrees,
keep going.
The oldest recruit on the course, number 5 Stacy, is struggling at the back.
What do you want to do?
VW.
You want a VW? Give me a number. All right, for you, it's over. All right, go back down. Slightly to look at me. Go and get yourself down there. All right, get your hat back on. Away you go.
Yeah, stop.
Now 15 remain.
Are you done?
No, stop.
Okay, then don't stop. You stop one more time, you're done. Come here. What's the rules?
Don't stop, stop.
Then stop fucking stopping. Go. 16 and 8. You are now 9 minutes behind. Come on!
20 minutes into the climb, number 8 Paige is also trailing at the back.
I would consider myself quite fit, but that's all dependent on what challenges I am to face. I've never been abroad, so don't know what the abroad heat is like. I can only relate to Newcastle heat and sunbeds, so I can't really comment on that one.
Show us you want to be here! Let's go, mountain goats! Who is that stopping? You done? You just quit 19?
No staff.
You want me to take your badge?
No staff.
That's your last warning.
No staff.
Number 19, Tom, is starting to fall behind the leaders.
So I don't really like being criticised.
Close the gap! 19.
Staff. When I was younger, whether it was sport or education or whatever it was I was doing, I never felt like I was good enough. I think I've learnt with age that criticism isn't a negative thing and that you can actually use it to make yourself better and improve.
If I get up there before you close that gap, you are done, 19. I'm coming for your ass. Get out of my way. Pack leaders, get up there, pack leaders. That's you, 19. Good job, 19. You're lucky you closed that gap.
Thank you, staff. Come on, number 2, good effort.
Recruit number 2, Dylan, is the first to reach the top of the dune. Closely followed by number 19, Tom.
Good effort, 19.
And number 17, Parnia.
Good effort, 17, Bergen off, tuck into the rocks, get some water on board. Enough of the fist bumping, fucking hell.
15, what are you doing? I told you multiple times, don't stop.
I'm done. Take it.
50 minutes into the climb.
Sit down, 15.
Number 15, Nick, voluntarily withdraws from the course. Now, 14 recruits remain.
Come on, 13. Fucking walking like C-3PO.
The final recruits to arrive at the RV are number 8, Paige.
Number 8, all the way in.
Head up!
And in last place, number 14, Jody.
Put your Bergen down, get some water on board. Don't pass out.
The recruits have now made it to the top. But what they don't know is that the task isn't over.
This was your warm-up. Now we're gonna get to the real games.
Sprint down to Foxy. Do it now.
Go, 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 go!
At a gradient of 45 degrees, the recruits must now sprint up and down the dune continuously.
Bergen's off and straight back up. Let's go.
Until two more withdraw from the course.
If you want it, you're gonna take it. Let's go. 17's breaking away, 19. It's a fight. 2. Okay, somebody wants it. Number 2.
Dog fight. I love it.
All the way down to the next tier. This is the dark place you've got to thrive in.
A continuous sickener is to replicate war.
You should not be walking! Get moving!
You never know when war's going to finish. You don't know when a firefight's going to finish.
Come on then, number 8. This is the fight I was talking about.
After struggling on the climb, number 8 Paige is now less than a minute behind the leader.
Fucking good effort. Well done. Dig deep now. Take her. You deserve to be in front of me. Now go. Come on.
We're looking for the people that have got the ability to keep digging deep when you don't know where the end is.
You want to be here, 9? Do you want to be here?
Yes,
sir. You fucking want to be here? Turn and burn!
It is a way of we're sealing out the weaker members that haven't got the mental stamina to keep going.
Number 9, pick up your Bergen. I can spit further than you've got to fucking walk.
Don't I? Hurry up! Let go!
Number 9, what are you doing? You look like a zombie.
Come on, Reese. Come on.
Stuff.
What do you want to do?
VW stuff.
Leave your heart and your soul on the mountain, didn't you?
Stuff.
Good effort. Go sit over there, grab some water. Well done.
Number 9, Vince voluntarily withdraws from the course.
Come on, 14.
Are you done, 14? You can't stop. Are you done, yes or no?
Sit down. I'm proud of you. You understand?
With number 14, Jody, handing in her armband, the sickener is over.
Let's go! Get your head up!
Now, 12 recruits remain.
That was brutal.
That was savage.
Right, Foxy, do the honors.
When you're gone, you stay gone.
All right, so we're focusing on mindset now. What did you see, Foxy?
If I'm honest, they were all hurting when they came in, but I have to say, 17 is a fucking ox.
She's big and grit.
She's impressing me, man.
Very much so.
I've got to tell you.
Yeah, I agree. She's really putting everything into it.
Yeah.
19 is still steady, steady as hell.
I was really impressed with him. Yeah, what I liked about it was he never gave attitude, he never quit. Number 8, she was hurting bad. I didn't think she was gonna make it, but she kept driving hard.
In fact, at the end, number 8 came in and I was like, where the fuck have you come from?
She's started to step into the limelight for the right reasons.
Yeah.
Yes. All right, let's bring her in.
Yeah.
Sound good?
Yeah.
Number 8!
Let's go!
Man, number 8, to the wall.
After showing resilience on the previous task, the DS want to find out where number 8 Page's motivation comes from.
One step down. Watch your step. Forward. Shift to the right.
How do you think you're getting on?
I've had a bit of a roller coaster. I think I've done quite well.
Well, you actually did all right. I was impressed.
We all saw a change in you.
It takes us a while to get in a stride. And if I can find that mindset, I can get into it, but it takes us a while.
We don't have a while.
Where does it come from?
I don't know. When I was younger, me brothers and sisters and mum and everybody, it was just like, oh, it's Fluffy Bunny Page. She lives in this world of her own.
So who put you down? Your brothers, your mom? What about your father?
My dad never did. He always believed that. Like, he always wanted us to do really good.
So why don't you listen to that voice?
Yeah.
How is your relationship right now with your dad?
I lost my dad 2 years ago.
You lost him?
Yes. And committed suicide.
Oh, I guess that knocked the shit out of you, right?
Yeah, I suppose it did. It was quite hard, because he was somebody who I'd viewed as the most strongest person.
Right.
In my life. And to see somebody not believe in themselves like he did and just fall into that depressive state and kind of not be able to come out of it. Yeah, that scares the shit out of us, because I've seen the one strongest man in my life happened to him. So Yeah.
Is your old man part of the reason you're here?
Yeah. Dealing with that situation because I was, like, there, like, it was me who cut him down. And my mental resilience that I'd showed, as much as how much I wanted to give up at that point, seeing him like that, I just kept going forward. And I didn't know what it was, and I just wanted to find out what that resilience is.
How far you could push yourself.
Yeah, because I didn't realise I had that much until I'd seen how I dealt with that.
That is a massive weapon in your armoury.
It's going to get harder. Mm-hmm. You are capable. You do have potential. Stay focused.
OK.
Guard.
Stand. To the side. Turn around.
That's sad.
Yeah.
I think you're doing great, kid.
Thanks. I've definitely became stronger because of the past few years.
I did all of these things at one time for the first time, and they were hard for me too. It's a combination of mental, physical, and emotional strength. And all three have to be balanced.
Yes, sir. I feel like I could be a dark horse on this course. I do think people will naturally underestimate how determined I am. Hopefully I can prove them wrong.
Right, front bicep, go.
Yeah!
He's a beast, isn't he?
Thanks, man. I've been training.
Have you?
Just earlier today, actually.
It's halfway through the course, and of the 20 recruits who began, 12 remain.
I won the competition for worst tattoo as well.
What's your tat?
I got party in my pants with balloons.
Oh, how funny.
How much action did you get for that, though?
Most people hated it, actually.
Recruits! Go ahead and get them out!
Head on after the vehicles.
Let's go!
Front vehicle, second vehicle, third, third.
The recruits are heading back to the dunes. After being tested on their mental endurance...
Let's go! Stay together!
Next, the DS want to test their aggression.
All right, this is called murderball. You have to give 100%. There are no timeouts. You can never show weakness. You understand?
Yes, sir.
You will be split up into two teams. One team will be on that side, other team will be on that side.
Hurry up! Let's get this moving, let's go!
The teams must fight for possession of the tyre.
At the top there, line your Bergens out like that, so the Bergens will create your goal line.
To win, they must get it across the opposing team's line.
Number 8 and 13.
Number 13, Sarah, will go head-to-head with number 8, Paige.
Go! Right, smash it! I'm a clam! I'm a fucking clam!
Come on, Paige, that's it.
Come on, Paige.
Come on, Paige.
Go on, Paige. Yes.
Get in there now. Go round her. Go. On your feet. If you're on your feet, you can move.
Nice. Get her off.
Don't see, there you go. Pull it up. Rip it. And number 3.
To make the fight unfair, number 3, Claire, is brought in to assist Sarah.
Hold her down. Hold her down.
2 against 1. Why don't you talk? Communicate. That's right. Warrior mindset.
You've got this, Paige!
Four! 18!
To even up the teams, number 18, Shyla, is brought onto the pitch.
Come on, then!
Oh, fuck it.
Pass the Paige!
Go, 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 Paige! Go, 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 Paige!
And clear. clears a path for her teammate.
Go, Pete!
Come on, Ed. You've got the advantage,
oh,
go!
Don't fucking waste it!
You've got it!
Get
there!
You've got it!
Keep going!
What?
Go! Good effort! I knew you had it in you!
Paige's team wins the bout.
Ash!
Go!
What? Go on!
Get the car! Let's go!
Murderball is all about getting the recruits to start thinking about how to employ aggression and overcome an enemy in a situation that they've not been able to plan for.
17!
To win any battle, whether it's long distance or close quarter, you need fucking aggression.
16!
You have to be able to go head first into some shit.
You're going the wrong way, 17! Stop!
Very good effort.
Good effort, 17! Number 8!
After winning the first round, number 8, Paige, is paired up with number 16, Kat.
Number 4 and 17!
To go against number 4, Abigail, and number 17, Pania.
When I was younger, I was angry at life. I was angry at growing up in... just with parents that shouldn't have been together.
All right, let me know when you're ready.
But now, I'm not angry anymore. I've made peace with it. You can't choose the cards you've been dealt, but you can choose how you play them.
Away you go! Get in, you trail pair! Number 1!
The DS instruct number 1, Jamie,
let's go,
to join next.
Come on!
Go ahead.
Shit.
Stop there!
Oh, fuck. I hope she's okay. Oh, shit.
Just lie flat for me.
I'm sorry,
lie
just...
flat for me. Just gonna pop you on a bit of oxygen just for a minute. Neck feeling sore? Any tingling or numbness in your hands?
I got 17s, alright?
Yeah, I feel shit now.
You shouldn't feel shit, Jamie, because it's part of the fucking game, man.
I want you to look at my finger and keep your head still.
After number 17, Pania suffered a head injury during Murderball.
All right.
Chief Medical Officer Salia is assessing if she's well enough to stay on the course.
Coming in.
Does that feel a bit? Okay. Okay. All right. People witnessed you having a loss of consciousness. With that in mind, I'm going to have to medically withdraw you.
No. Please, let me have a say on this.
You lost consciousness. We cannot risk you.
A brain and nervous system injury, or the possibility of one, can be fatal. And we have more violence ahead on this course, 17. Do you understand?
No, I get it.
It has to be the call. Fucking great effort. Fantastic.
Keep it going. Let's go!
Faster. Sprint.
When you are driving through a hostile environment, you're vulnerable to an ambush. Your vehicle becomes your tool of escape. Your vehicle becomes your weapon. You have not got time to mess about. You have to get out. Fastest, safest, quickest means that you possibly can. There's no room for error.
As a final test of their mindset, the recruits will come under attack whilst driving in a simulated war zone.
You will drive through multiple checkpoints, a border crossing, and to a safe zone. You must maintain a cool mindset. Do you understand?
Yes, sir. Yeah.
Number one.
You can drive, right?
Yes, sir.
Let's go.
First to go is recruit number one, Jamie. On entering the compound, the recruits will be subjected to an ambush.
What's coming? Anything from the right or the left?
It's a car, Stas. It's a car.
The DS are lying in wait.
Which way are we going to go? Let's go right! Let's get out of here! Let's go right!
And will further attack the vehicle.
Yes! What's happening behind us? It's what are we going to do? What are we going
to
do?
To pass the task, they must escape to safety.
Fuck you! What's going to do?
By breaking through the barrier.
Climb out.
You're happy with that decision?
I am, sir.
Okay, well done. Good effort.
Number one, Jamie, successfully completes the task.
Number eight, sprint to Billy now. Sprint!
Next up is recruit number eight, Paige.
You can drive, right?
Yes, sir.
You can?
Initially, to pressure, I get really nervous. I kind of get a bit flustered.
Calm down, just drive. Try in gear, get in gear.
But hopefully I'll be able to get that under control and really truly sure that I am capable.
The smoke! Fuck! Ah, Gary, you'll get in there now! What else is happening with that car? Let's go!
It's air goggles.
Okay, then block the fucking road. Which way are we gonna go? Let's go! Fuck's sake! Slow down! Slow down! What's happening? What's happening in front of us? What's happening behind us? What are we gonna do? What's doing now? Where are we going?
Right, what was in your head?
Do
you think? Was it?
Frantic stuff.
You went to ratchet, didn't you?
Yes, sir.
Consequently, I'm fucking dead and you're dead.
Yes, sir.
You failed this task, all right? Yes, you told me you could drive.
No, I recently passed my test.
Oh, fucking great.
The driving ambush is important because under duress, you need to make split-second decisions. Seconds can cost lives.
What are we gonna do? We're gonna drop the fucking eight! Stop! Stop!
I've missed death by milliseconds.
Where are we gonna go?
We're gonna go straight.
Let's go right, let's go right, 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 right!
I took a round straight through my windshield in an ambush.
A man in front of us!
What are we gonna do?
My team leader was shot right next to me.
Okay, oh shit!
On the block, on the block.
With enemies surrounding me, three of my tires and my Humvee were blown out.
There's a car coming
up. Okay, let's speed it up then!
Bullets and RPGs going all around us. We're in the battle of our lives.
Fuck it, I'm going through!
Keeping a cool head in chaos.
What's happening behind us? Where are we gonna go?
That's what separates special operations and everybody else.
What are we going to do?
The barrier,
what's happening? It was a good decision. Well done.
Yes, sir.
Number 19, get over here.
Last to go is recruit number 19, Tom.
How are you feeling about this right now?
A bit anxious, Staff.
You don't want to quit, though, do you?
No, Staff.
Okay.
I want to give this my best.
So what do you need to do? Work through it, right?
Focus.
Right.
Concentrate on the job.
Being nervous is not going to help the situation. So suck it up, take a deep breath, and get it done.
In the past, I was a bit of an asshole. Going out, drinking as a young lad, trying to be all macho.
Take your hat off, put it in your pocket right now.
But things changed for me, really, when I met my wife.
Let's go!
Run, run, run! Sprint, sprint!
She's definitely helped me get on the straight and narrow.
Let's go then, start the engine. Come on, let me stay, so we're getting fucking blown to pieces here. Stay in control of the vehicle.
Oh, fuck, what the fuck was that? Any people coming?
There's coming over.
What's that car coming over?
Car coming over.
Oh, fuck, what are they doing? Which way are we going to go? We're going to go right. Let's go right. Which way? Right, right. Which way is that? What's happening?
We're going to go right.
What the fuck are we going to do? What's happening behind us?
Down at the border.
What the fuck are we going to do? What are we going to do? What are we going to do? What are we going to do?
We're going to go start.
Make a fucking decision. Come on.
We're going to go back start.
Stop!
Get out. Move to the front.
What the fuck was that? What was your decision?
I wanted to go back, Staff.
You fucked up, didn't you?
Yes, Staff. Should have drove at him. Got
well,
him to move.
Should have and could have. You fucking didn't. Consequently, we both fucking strung up now. So Staff. You failed, didn't you?
Yes, Staff.
Disappeared over there. Go.
Yeah, so I don't
want to
talk.
Okay. All right, mate. I know it's fucking rough, that.
All right, get in the vehicles.
So frustrated at myself.
Just breathe, mate. Right.
Yeah.
Nineteen.
I saw that coming.
After his emotional reaction on the driving ambush, the DS wanted to dig deeper into number 19's background.
Tell us a little something about yourself, 19.
What would you like to know, Staff?
You got a relationship? You got kids?
I haven't got any kids, but I've got a wife.
You're getting very emotional. What's up?
My wife's a very, very brave person, and I've seen how strong she is, and I just want to show that I'm strong as well.
What you been going through?
So two years ago, we were driving to a birthday party and a car coming around the corner ended up on the wrong side of the road and we were in a head-on collision. And they managed to get me out. I had to wait about an hour, not knowing.
Take your time.
Yeah, it's all right.
Not knowing if I would see her again or if she was going to turn up at the hospital. And when she finally did, they brought her bed in next to mine and the doctors came in and they confirmed that she had fractured her spine in two different places. And it was just told to us that she may never walk again and time will tell if it will heal or not. So for 2.5 months, I didn't work. And I just spent every day at the hospital with her. She's made a great recovery. She's so strong, determined. She's since ran a half marathon. And she's training for a marathon that she plans to run next year, which I'm going to be running with her.
You're through that phase now, right? Mm. Obviously, it still hurts you. It's still emotional when you think about it and talk about it, but...
I just don't know if there's something I could have done different, if I could have seen
what
was
coming.
Does it
matter now? She's back in a good place, right?
Yes.
You've still got it?
Yeah.
And actually, it sounds like she's kicking your fucking ass.
She is, and that's why I want to prove myself.
And that's a great mindset. So I'm hoping you've got the same, because you're going to need it.
Yeah. I let it get to me today.
If you can learn from it, it's not a failure. So you really think about that tonight. You should learn from this.
Yes, Staff.
God.
thing that I love most about Helen, she's been thrown a lot of challenges. And she's always stayed positive, always stayed focused, and never let anything beat her. If I'm ever struggling, or things ever feel tough, I just think about what she had to go through and how strong she stayed.
All good?
Yeah. That's all I need to do, and I'll get through it. If she can do that, then, yeah.
Next time.
Let's go, Mountain Goats!
Through Special Forces selection.
Keep going!
Everything about you will be exposed.
Yes!
Proud of you. Give me something.
You better not stop again, or I'm dropping your ass.
You must trust one another.
Wait for your partner!
Implicitly.
Do you have what it takes to survive SAS selection? Go to channel4.com/takepart for more information.